Now let's discuss about Indonesian verbs. In Bahasa Indonesia or Indonesian language, sometimes it is confusing because sometimes the verb using prefix and sometimes using suffix and sometimes using both prefix and suffix. Okay. The most important thing is we have to know the verb base first. Okay, for example, I make here five examples, five words, verbs. For initial sounds is a. Okay. Okay. Let's practice. Ajak here, ajak, antar, angkat, ambil, ayun. Okay. So in Bahasa Indonesia, usually transitive verb means that the verb uses an object. In Bahasa Indonesia, sometimes the verb base using prefix me, mem, meng, meng. Okay, sometimes some verbs using prefix me, mem, meny, meng. Okay, so if you find a verb base, the initial sound or the first letter is a in Bahasa Indonesia, a. So you have to put prefix meng before the verb base. Mengajak, mengantar, mengangkat, mengambil, mengayun. So the sounds will be here ajak, here mengajak. So there are three syllables here, mengajak. So ng followed by letter a with nga, yeah. Me, me, ngantar, yeah. Me, ngangkat. Me, ngambil. Me, ngayun. So this is nga. Okay, yeah. Ajak, mengajak, bukan mengajak, no, but mengajak. Okay. Antar, mengantar. Okay. Angkat, mengangkat. Ambil, mengambil. Ayun, mengayun. The first one, remember, if you find verb base, the first letter is a, you have to put prefix meng, meng, okay, meng. But the pronunciation will be mengajak, not mengajak, yeah. Mengajak, mengantar, mengangkat, mengambil, mengayun. Okay, that's all I can say. Yeah, in Bahasa Inggris or in English, persuade, mengajak, deliver, mengantar, mengangkat, lift, mengambil, take, mengayun, sway. Okay, I'll continue this topic with the verb base with initial letter, initial sound with B. Okay, here A and then B. I'll see you again, thank you. Let's continue to the letter verb base with the first letter is B. B. In Indonesian language, we learn verb base so that we can learn how to make the prefix, because it is different if the word, if the verb followed the first letter is A, B, C, D, or etc. And then the prefix is different. Okay, for verb base, the first letter is B, and then we put mem, prefix mem, before the verb base. For example, beri, memberi. Okay, beri, memberi. Bawa, membawa. Bagi, membagi. Buat, membuat. Bantu, membantu. Okay, remember, for the verb base, if the initial letter is B, so the prefix is mem. Okay, usually the verb base is used for a command sentence. For example, beri aku uang, give me money. Bawakan aku makanan, bawa aku makanan. Yeah, let's continue with the verb base. The first letter is C. If you find the first letter, the verb base of Indonesian language is C, so we have to put prefix men before the verb base. Let's practice. Cari, mencari. In English, look for. Curi, mencuri. In English, steal. Contoh, mencontoh. Imitate. Caci, mencaci. Mock. Cuci, mencuci. Wash or clean. Let's practice. Cari, curi, contoh, caci, cuci. Mencari, mencuri, mencontoh, mencaci, mencuci. So I give here the translation, the four English words. So mencari means look for, mencuri means steal, mencontoh means imitate, mencaci means mock, mencuci means wash or clean. Yeah, I'll see you later with the next letter, verb base with the first letter D. I'm Gunawan Tamunsaribu, thank you for watching, goodbye. Yeah, let's continue to the verb base with the first letter is D. In Bahasa Indonesia, if you find the verb base with the first letter is D, so we have to put prefix men, men, before the verb base. Let's practice. Didik, mendidik. Dorong, mendorong. Dengar, mendengar. Daki, mendaki. Dayung, mendayung. Yeah. So I put here the English words. Mendidik means educate. Mendorong means push. Mendengar, listen or hear. Mendaki, climb or go up. Mendayung, pedal or row. Yeah, let's repeat from the beginning. Didik, dorong, dengar, daki, dayung. And then we put prefix men before the verb base. Mendidik, mendorong, mendengar, mendaki, mendayung. So I'm Gunawan Tamunsaribu, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next with other topic. Goodbye. Is with the first letter A. A. Okay, if you find the first letter of verb base in Indonesian language A, for example, these five words, So we have to put mừng, prefix mừng before the verb. Okay, for example, edar, mengedarkan. Okay, the verb edar, we have to put mừng, prefix mừng, and suffix kan. Okay, so this is transitive verb. Edar, mengedarkan. Ejek, edar, mengedarkan. Remember, this is one syllable. Nge, 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 nge. So this is one syllable. We don't separate ng and e, but this is one sound. Nge. Remember, edar, mengedarkan. Ejek, ejek, mengejek, not mengejek. This is one sound, ng, ng and e, the sound is ng. Ekspor, meng, ekspor, mengekspor. Okay, this is the borrowing word from English. And in Bahasa Indonesia, the letter is X with K, not X. Ekspor, mengekspor. Eksekusi, eksekusi, mengeksekusi, mengeksekusi, mengek, this is one sound, mengeksekusi. Edukasi, this is also a borrowing word from English, educate. Edukasi, mengedukasi. All right, so I write here the English word, I mean the translation, so you can learn or compare between Indonesian and English also. I do hope this will be helpful for you. All right, let's practice more. Edar, mengedarkan. Yeah, we have to put suffix kan here, because mengedar, that is not a good verb in Bahasa Indonesia, right? Mengedarkan, that is a transitive verb. Yeah. Ejek, mengejek. Ekspor, mengekspor. Eksekusi, mengeksekusi. Edukasi, mengedukasi. Alright, I do hope this will be will be helpful for you to learn Indonesian language. I'm Gunawan Tambu Saribu. I'll see you next week at a topic. Alright, guys, we continue to the verb base with the first letter G. In Indonesian language, if you find verb base with the first letter is G, so we have to put prefix meng, right? Meng. All the words, all these verbs are transitive verbs. That means that this verb needs an object, alright? So, let's practice. Goreng, menggoreng. So this is one sound. Meng, 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 meng. Alright? Goreng, menggoreng. In English, fry. Ganggu, mengganggu. Disturb. Ganti, mengganti. Replace. Gosok, menggosok. If you want to say menggosok tangan, rub your hands. But if you want to say menggosok pakaian, iron the clothes. Right? Gendong. Gendong means you put something on your back. I mean carry pick a bag. Carry pick a bag. Okay. Goreng, menggoreng. Ganggu, mengganggu. Ganti, mengganti. Gosok, menggosok. Gendong, menggendong. So you find here the English words. So I mean, if you want to compare between Indonesian language and the translation into English. So I'm Gunawanta Muncharibu. I'll see you next week at a topic. Thank you. Guys, we continue to the verb base with the first letter G. In Indonesian language, if you find verb base with the first letter is G, so we have to put prefix meng, right? Meng. All the words, all these verbs are transitive verbs. That means that this verb needs an object, alright? So, let's practice. Goreng, meng goreng. So this is one sound. Meng, 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 meng. Alright? Goreng, meng goreng. In English, fry. Ganggu, meng ganggu. Disturb. Ganti, meng ganti. Replace. Gosok, menggosok. If you want to say menggosok tangan, rub your hands. But if you want to say menggosok pakaian, iron the clothes. Right? Gendong. Gendong means you put something on your back. I mean carry pick a bag. Carry pick a bag. Okay. Goreng, menggoreng. Ganggu, mengganggu. Ganti, mengganti. Gosok, menggosok. Gendong, menggendong. So you find here the English words. So I mean, if you want to compare between Indonesian language and the translation into English. So I'm Gunawanta Muncharibu. I'll see you next week at a topic. Thank you. Alright, so now let's discuss with the base verb with the first letter ha. If you find in Indonesian verb, the first letter for the verb base is ha, so we have to put prefix meng before the verb. Let's practice. Hasut, meng hasut. You find here the translation into English, so if you are the speaker of English, you know the meaning of those words, right? Hirup, menghirup means inhale. Harap, mengharapkan, hope or wish. So especially for kata harap, we use prefix meng and also suffix kan, mengharapkan. Hitung, menghitung, in English, count. Hargai, menghargai means appreciate. Let's practice more. Hasut, hirup, harap, hitung, hargai. Menghasut, menghirup, mengharapkan, menghitung, menghargai. So I'm Gunawanta Muncharibu. I'll see you next week at a topic. Maybe we continue with the first letter E. Thank you. Let's now continue to the verb base with the first letter E. If you find the verb base in Indonesian verb with the first sound E, so we have to put prefix meng in front of or before the verb base. Let's practice. Intip, intip, mengintip. Remember, this is one sound. If you find the sound ng and the vowel here, so this is ngin, mengintip, mengimpor, mengikat, mengimbangi, mengikuti. Ng with this, if you find the sound of ng followed by a vowel sound, this is because this becomes one sound. Remember, intip, mengintip. Impor, impor, mengimpor. Impor is the borrowing word from English. Impor, mengimpor. Ikat, ikat, mừng nhì khật im ba nhì mừng im ba nhì y cụ thị mừng nhì cụ thị. Let's practice more. Im tiếp mừng nhìn tiếp im por mừng im por y khật mừng nhì khật im ba nhì mừng im ba nhì y cụ thị mừng nhì cụ thị. So you find here the translation into English so that you know the meaning of those verbs. Mừng im tiếp in Bahasa Inggris, in English peep. Mừng im por because this is a boring word from English import. Mừng ikat means tie. Mừng imbangi means balance. Mừng ikuti means follow. Alright, let's practice more. Im tip, mừng im tip. Impor, mừng impor. Ikat, mừng ikat. Imbangi, mừng imbangi. Ikuti, mừng ikuti. So that's all for today. Thank you so much, and I'll see you next with other verb base. I'm Gunawan Tamunsari. Thank you for watching. Let's now continue to the verb base with the first letter J. J. Okay, let's practice. Jalani. So if you want to make two transitive verb, means that these verbs must need an object. So we have to put prefix men. Remember, if the verb base the first letter J with the first letter J or J in Indonesian language, we have to put prefix men. Yeah, come on, practice after me. Jalani, menjalani. Okay, I write here the translation into English so that we know the meaning of those verbs, these verbs. Okay, jalani, menjalani. Undergo or go through. Jaga, menjaga. Yeah, take a look after or keep. Jajah, menjajah. Colonize. Jadikan, menjadikan. Make or create. Jodohkan, menjodohkan. Match up. Okay, let's try from the beginning. Jalani, menjalani. Jaga, menjaga. Jajah, menjajah. Jadikan, menjadikan. Jodohkan, menjodohkan. Okay, that's all about the verb base with the first letter J. And we have to put prefix men in front of the verb base. Okay, so thank you. I'm Gunawan Tamunsari. I will see you next with other topic. Goodbye. Let's continue to learn about Indonesian verbs with the verb base and with the first letter K. If you find the first letter, the initial letter is K, we have to put prefix meng, and then, this is very unique, and then you omit the K, the K letter, if you have to put prefix. So we have to delete or omit the letter of K. For example, kurung mengurung. So, see, there is no any K letter here anymore. So there is no mengkurung, no, but mengurung. Remember, if you find ng followed by vowel, so this is one sound. Ng, 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 ng. Alright, let's practice more. Kurung mengurung. In English, imprison. Kurangi, kurangi, mengurangi. See, there is no any k anymore. Yeah. So we have to omit k letter after we use prefix meng. Kunci mengunci. Kekang mengekang. Kejar mengejar. Remember, the verb base with the first letter k, if we have used meng, prefix meng, we omit or delete the k letter, becomes kurung, becomes mengurung. Kurangi, mengurangi. Kunci, mengunci. Kekang, mengekang. Kejar, mengejar. Okay, you find here the English translation, the translation into English, so that we can understand what is the meaning of those verbs. So I'm Gunawan Damsaru. Thank you for watching, and I do hope this very this will be helpful for you to learn about Indonesian. Yeah, let's continue to the verb base with the first letter L. L. So if you find the verb base with the first letter L in Indonesian language, we have to put prefix me. Me. Alright, let's practice. Lempar. Lempar. Melempar. Lompat. Melompat. Laju. Melaju. Lirik, melirik. Lebur, melebur. Remember, you have to put me if the verb base with the first letter L. So, let's practice more. Lempar, melempar. Lompat, melompat. Laju, melaju. Lirik, melirik. Lebur, melebur. You find here the translation into English so that we know the meaning of those verbs. So I'm Gunawan Damsaru. I thank you for watching this video. I do hope this topic will be very helpful for you to learn about Indonesian language. Thank you. Continue our lesson for today with the verb base with the first letter M. If you find the verb base in Indonesian verbs with the sound or the first letter M, so we have to put prefix me, remember, me, before the base verb. Let's practice. Makan, makan, memakan. Minum, meminum. Maki, memaki. Masak, memasak. Masuki, memasuki. Let's practice more. Makan, memakan. In English, eat. Minum, meminum. The English, drink. Maki, memaki. Mok. Masak, memasak. Cook. Masuki, memasuki. Enter or get in. Remember, if you find the verb base with the first letter M, we have to put prefix me before the verbs. So I'm Gunawan Damsaru. Thank you so much, and I suggest you to practice more so that you will be fluent in pronunciation of Indonesian. Thank you so much. Goodbye. Yes, we continue the verb base with the first letter P. In Indonesian verbs, we have to know the prefix me, mem, men, and meng, but the use is different. It's related to the first letter of the verb base. Remember, if you find the verb base with the first letter P, so the prefix is me. Let's practice. Pecat, memecat. Remember, the word, the letter P is omitted, right? And we replace pe with m. So pechat, me mechat, not me pechat, no, but me mechat. So pechat, me mechat, pindahkan, memindahkan, putar, memutar, pikirkan, memikirkan, potong, memotong. Remember, if you find the verb place with the first letter P in AND, we have to put prefix M and we have to omit or delete the letter P. We replace P with M. Remember, pecat, memecat, pindahkan, memindahkan, putar, memutar, pikirkan, memikirkan, potong, memotong. So I write here the translation into English so that we know the meaning of those verbs from Indonesian into English. So I'm Gunawan Tambun Saribu. I do hope this topic will be very helpful for you to make your Indonesian language will be fluent. Thank you so much. I'm Gunawan Tambun Saribu. This with the first letter R. R in Indonesian language, R in English, R. Come on, let's try. Rang, rong, 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 rong. Okay, there are two syllables here. Rong, rong, me, rong, rong. So, okay, the first thing we know is if the verb base with the first letter R. So we have to put prefix me in front of the verb base. Okay? Yeah. So, remember, let me tell you, prefix me, men, men, meng, all the verbs are transitive, means that the verb needs an object after a verb. Alright? So this is the verb base. Let me tell you, the verb base is usually used for command sentence. Yeah, command sentence. Alright? Yeah. Rong rong, me rong rong. Rendahkan, merendahkan. Redakan, redakan, meredakan. Rendahkan, merendahkan. Redakan, meredakan. Rintih, merintih. Runtuhkan, meruntuhkan. Okay, so I write here a translation into English so that we know the meaning of these verbs. Okay, let's practice more. Rong rong, merong rong. In English, undermine. Rendahkan, merendahkan means lower or degrade. Redakan, meredakan in English ease or alleviate. Rintih, merintih, moan or groan. Runtuhkan, meruntuhkan, overthrow or demolish. So that's all about my explanation about verb base with the first letter R. In Bahasa Indonesia, the sound is R. Thank you. Yeah, now we go on to the first letter with the verb base S. S. This is very unique, remember? Because when we use prefix men, we have to add also Y or Ye. So this will be one sound. Nya, nyi, nye, nyum. Okay, so we have to omit S. So we have to omit S and then we put ye. So take the word, we omit S here. So you take those letters. Okay, let me repeat. sadari, menyadari. Come on, repeat up to me. Sadari, menya. So this is one sound. Nya, menyadari, nyadari. Realize in English. Sikat, sikat, menyikat. So this is one sound. Nyi, 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 nya, nyi. Menyadari, menyikat. Okay. Sebar, menyebar, nye. So N with Y and E. So this one sound nye, nye. Okay. Sukai, sukai, menyukai, nyu, nyu. Sumpahi, menyumpahi, nyum, nyum. Okay, repeat out to me. Sadari, menyadari, realize. Sikat, menyikat, brush. Remember, in Indonesian language, the final sound is not plosive. I mean, sikat, like, there is no t, there is no sound, usually. Yeah, remember, sikat, not sikat. It sounds weird in for Indonesian people. Okay, but if you say sikat, that's no big problem. Indonesian people will understand that you are not a native speaker of Indonesian language. Okay, sikat, menyikat, brush. Sebar, menyebar, spread. Sukai, menyukai. So this is three syllables. Sukai, menyukai. Not menyukai, tapi menyukai. Menyukai. Sumpahi, sumpahi, menyumpahi. Alright. Yeah, I write also the translation into English here, so we know the meaning of those verbs. So I'm Gunawan Tamusarugu. I'll see you next week with other topic. Goodbye. Yeah, let's try to continue to read, to add our vocabulary by knowing the verb base and the prefix. Okay, now we continue to the first letter T. In Indonesian language, the sound is T. Okay, tanam, tanam. Menanam. Remember, the uniqueness is when the verb base with the first letter T. So we have to omit T sound, T sound, T letter. So we say those letters, these letters. Menanam. So we have to put prefix me and then added by N. Me, na, nam. So this is one sound. Na, num, nim, nin, nu. Okay? Yeah. So remember, if you find verb base with the first letter T or te in Indonesian language, we have to put prefix me and then add it by N. N. So you have to replace the letter T with M. Remember? Nanam. So this will be M, yeah? If you put prefix me and then menanam, not metanam, but menanam. Okay? So let's practice. Tanam, menanam. Okay. Menanam. Tumbuk, tumbuk, menumbuk. Timbang, timbang, menimbang, menimbang. Tindih, tindih, menindih, menindih. Tutup, tutup, menutup. Okay, let's practice more. ta nắm mơ na nằm tùm búc mơ nùm búc tìm băng mơ nìm băng tìm đi mơ nìm đi tù túc mơ nụ túc. So I write down the translation into English so that we know how to compare. I mean, then we know the meaning of these verbs. Manana means in English plant. Menumbuk means mash or grind. Menimbang means weigh. Menindi overlap or oppress. Menutup close or shut. Okay, that's all of my explanation about the verb base with the first letter T. And then if you make into transitive verbs, we have to put prefix M added by N. N is the replacement of T or T here. So this will be menanam, not metanam. T replaced by N, and then after T followed by those vowel A, U, I, E, U. So here it is, menanam. So N is the replacement from T. So I'm Gunawan Tamu Saribu. I'll see you next with other topic. Goodbye. Yes, now we go on to this topic. Verb base with the first letter U. In Bahasa Indonesia or in Indonesian language, the sound is U. Remember, if the verb base with the first letter U, so we have to put prefix meng. Meng. Okay, all right. So practice after me. Unggah, unggah, mengunggah. Remember, even though the prefix is meng, but this is not one sound, but it is separated. Okay, let's practice. Ungga, mengungga. Ulur, mengulur. Umpan, mengumpan. Usir, mengusir. Ubah, mengubah. So I write here the translation into English so that we know the meaning of these verbs. Repeat after me, we practice more. Unggah, mengunggah, upload. Ulur, mengulur, extend. Umpan, mengumpan, feed or lure. Usir, mengusir, chase. Ubah, mengubah, change. That's all my explanation about verb base with the first letter U. Remember, we have to put prefix meng, but the sounds will be separated. Mengung, mengu, mengum, mengu, mengu. Alright? Not meng, ungga, meng, ulur. No. But this is one sound. Ngu, ngu, ngum, ngu, ngu. Mengungga, mengungga, mengulur, mengumpan, mengusir, mengubah. Alright, thank you. I'll see you next with our topic. Goodbye. Yeah, this is the last my last explanation about the verb base of Indonesian verbs. So why do I have to make this in one? In one explanation, because uniquely in Bahasa Indonesia or Indonesian language, V, W, X, Y, X usually, yeah, X. X, I hardly know a verb started with X. Yeah? Okay, VWE, I make one example of this letter because it is seldom in Bahasa Indonesia or Indonesian language, it is seldom a verb base started with VWE, yeah. Alright, so I make one example on also only. Yeah, vonis, vonis, mem vonis. Remember, if the verb base started with letter V, V, so we have to put prefix mem. Vonis, mem vonis. In Bahasa, in English, the translation is sentence or put into jail. Put into jail. Or sentence. Warnai, warnai, me warnai. Remember, if the verb base started with we, the letter is we, so the prefix will be me. Okay, the last one, yakini or yakinkan. So we have to put me also. Me, meyakini, meyakinkan, meyakini, meyakinkan, me. In Bahasa Indonesia it is called a puppet, but in English it is called a. Okay, a meyakini, meyakinkan. Yeah. All right. So, this is all about. This is all my explanation about Indonesian verbs. The verb base, if you make the verb base into transitive verb means that a verb needs an object, so we have to put prefix. Remember, study more about my previous from my previous video from A B C D F G H until E. So because all verbs is different. All the verbs are different related to the using of prefix. For example, ajar, we use mengajar. Yeah. Bedah, we use membedah. Yeah. Cantik, mempercantik. Okay. So, yeah. If you want to make your Indonesian language be fluent, more fluent, please listen or study from my video. I do hope my explanation will make you understand more about Indonesian language. Thank you so much. I'll see you next with another topic. Goodbye. So let's go to the morphology from intransitive verb into noun. So you can make a verb into noun in Bahasa Indonesia or Indonesian language by adding the same prefix and suffixes. For example, datang, come, kedatangan, coming. So it's the same formula. We have prefix ke and ended by suffix an. Yeah, in the middle of ke and an, there is an intransitive verb. Okay, pergi, pergi, kepergian. Yeah, leave, leaving. Okay. Pulang, yeah. Arrive, pulang atau tiba, pulang atau tiba, yeah. Kepulangan, arrival, yeah. We can say arriving, yeah. Berangkat, leave, leaving. Rindu, miss, missing. Okay, so it's the same formula, ke, prefix ke, followed by intransitive verb. And then ended by suffixes an. Okay, so all intransitive verb, yeah, okay, not all, some intransitive verb can we make into a noun by prefix ke followed by intransitive verb and ended by suffixes an. Okay, let we repeat. Datang kedatangan, pergi kepergian, pulang atau tiba kepulangan, berangkat keberangkatan, rindu kerinduan. Okay, intransitive verb is a verb which does not need an object. For example, in English, I sleep. I sleep at 9 o'clock every night. I come to you. It seems like, so those reverb come, sleep and seem. Yeah, they are called intransitive verb. The same in Bahasa Indonesia. All these verbs do not need an object. Okay. Yeah. Usually they need only an adverb of time, adverb of place. Yeah. For example, saya datang ke rumahmu. I come to your house. Kedatangan saya tiba-tiba. My arriving is sudden. Okay. Pergi. Yeah. I go to school every day. To school is adverb of place, not an object. I go to school. Kepergiannya tiba-tiba. Her leaving, her going is very sudden. Okay. Pulang. Okay, kepulangan. Saya pulang terlambat. I go home late. Yeah. Kepulangan. My going home is too late. Berangkat. Leave. I leave to Bali. I will leave Jakarta next week. Saya akan meninggalkan. Okay. Saya akan berangkat. Berangkat is the same with go. Pergi. Berangkat. I will go to Bali next week. Keberangkatanku. My going to Bali next weekend will be a plan for me. Okay. Rindu, missing. Okay, that's all about adjective into noun and intransitive verb into noun. There's a little bit morphology, a word processes or word formation in Indonesian language. So I'm Gunawan Tamusaribu. I will see you next with other topic. Goodbye. Thank you for viewing my video. Hello, saya Gunawan Tamusaribu. I want to discuss now about Indonesian intransitive verbs. Intransitive verbs means a verb that does not need an object. Okay. Yeah, it's like similar into English. You can see the translation into English right here. So I make here 15 verbs of Indonesian language. They are intransitive verbs. So the focus is how to pronounce or how to read or how to, the sound of the verb. Come on, repeat after me. Berangkat. Berangkat means leave in Bahasa English or in English. Come on. Berangkat. Okay, the second. Bekerja. Bekerja. Work. Yeah. Okay. The third. Berjalan. Berjalan. Berjalan means walk. Okay. The fourth. Bertemu. Bertemu, meet. Okay. The next, berkunjung. Berkunjung, drop by or come by. Okay. Berlibur. Berlibur. Berlibur, take holiday. Okay. Or take an off day. It's the same. Okay. Berdiri. Berdiri. Berdiri, stand. Bersandar, bersandar, lean on. Okay, what do we study from this, my left side? The verbs on my left side is the verbs that using prefix ber. Okay, ber. So you have to know that the specific intransitive verbs, mostly in Indonesian language, the verbs use prefix ber. Okay, come on. Ber or a b. Yeah. Ber or a b. Okay. So repeat after me. Berangkat, leave. Bekerja, work. Berjalan, walk. bertemu, meet, berkunjung, come by or drop by, berlibur, take a holiday or take an off day, berdiri, stand, bersandar, lean on. Okay, usually these verbs are followed by preposition. For example, berangkat ke kantor, leave to go to office. Bekerja di kantor, work in an office. So usually they are followed by preposition, adverb of time or adverb of place. Okay, so we go on to my right side. Okay, so they are also grouped into intransitive verbs. Same with in English words. Okay, pulang, return, or go back home. Pulang ke rumah, go back home. Pulang, return. Pergi, go. Duduk, sit. Masuk, get in, or come in. Keluar, get out, or come out. Naik, go up. Turun, go down. So this is, naik and turun is antonym. Masuk and keluar also they are antonym. Okay. Pulang pergi they are antonym. So repeat after me. Pulang, return. Pergi, go. Duduk, sit. Masuk, get in or enter. It's the same. Usually we see here enter, masuk, right? Keluar, get out or exit. Naik, go up. Turun, go down. So that's all about intransitive verbs in Bahasa Indonesia. I do hope this topic will be useful for you to add your vocabulary in Indonesian language. I'm Gunawan Tanmusaribu. I'll see you next week with another topic. Goodbye. Thank you. Yeah, as I remember, in Bahasa Indonesia, there are some synonyms referring to verb. So I begin with these two verbs, memerkosa and memenjarakan, ya. Memerkosa, memenjarakan. So those two verbs, there are the synonyms of these two verbs. The first one, memerkosa, means menggagahi. So if you listen to the word menggagahi, it means referring to memerkosa, it's the same meaning. Menggarap, the same meaning. Merenggut kegadisan, meniduri dengan paksa. So, memerkosa, there are four synonyms here. Menggagahi, menggarap, merenggut kegadisan, meniduri dengan paksa. So they have similar meaning with to rape. The second is to imprison or to put in jail. In Bahasa Indonesia, memenjarakan. So I find four verb phrases here with the similar meaning with memenjarakan. Memasukkan ke dalam bui. Ya, bui, jeruji, rumah tahanan, penjara. It means they are me. They have similar meaning with the noun prison. So memasukkan atau to put in. It means to put in. Memasukkan ke dalam penjara. Memasukkan ke dalam jeruji. Memasukkan ke rumah tahanan or ke dalam rumah tahanan. Memasukkan ke dalam penjara. So these four verb phrase is they have similar meaning with memenjarakan. In English, to imprison or to put in jail. So, Indonesian language has a very wide range of synonyms. Yeah. So maybe we continue with other verb synonym later on. So I begin today with two verb, to rape, to imprison, memerkosa, and memenjarakan. So, first phrase is if they have similar meaning with this. Alright? So I do hope you can add your vocabulary and you can practice how to use this verb phrase with the meanings, the synonym meaning to this verb. Thank you so much. I'm Gunawan Tanmusaribu. I'll see you next week with another topic. Goodbye. Yeah, now we study about Indonesian verbs.
20
most Indonesian verbs using by housewife at home. Okay, so let's practice. Memasak. Memasak. In English, cook. Menggoreng. Menggoreng. Fry. Mencuci. Mencuci. Wash. Menyapu. Menyapu. Sweep. Mengepel. Mengepel. Mop. Membersihkan. Membersihkan. Clean. Membilas. Membilas. Rinse. Menjemur. Menjemur. Dry. Menyikat. Menyikat. Brush. Merapikan. Merapikan. Tidy up. We continue. Mengiris. Mengiris. Slice. Memotong. Memotong. Cut. Mengisi. Mengisi. Fill. Membeli. Membeli. Buy. Membayar. Membayar. Pay. Berbelanja. Berbelanja. Shop. Menutup. Menutup. Close or shut. Membuka. Membuka. Open. Menyetrika. Menyetrika. Iron. Melipat. Melipat. Fold. Okay, let's practice more. Memasak. Cook. For example, memasak sayur. Cook vegetable. Menggoreng. Menggoreng. Fry. Menggoreng ikan. Fry fish. Mencuci. Mencuci. Wash. Mencuci pakaian. Wash clothes. Menyapu. Menyapu. Sweep. Menyapu lantai. Sweep the floor. Mengepel. Mengepel. Mop. Mengepel lantai. Mop the floor. Membersihkan. Membersihkan. Clean. Membersihkan meja. Clean the table. Membilas. Membilas. Rinse. Membilas pakaian. Rinse the clothes. Menjemur. Menjemur. Dry. Menjemur pakaian. Dry clothes. Menyikat. Menyikat. Brush. Menyikat pakaian. Brush the clothes. Merapikan. Merapikan. Merapikan meja. Tidy up the table. Mengiris. Mengiris. Slice. Mengiris cabai. Slice the... Mengiris bawang. Slice the onion. Memotong. Memotong. Cut. Memotong bawang. Cut the onion. Memotong daging. Cut the meat. Mengisi. Mengisi. Fill in. Mengisi cangkir. Fill in the cup. Membeli. Membeli. Buy. Membeli buah-buahan. Buy some fruits. Membayar. Membayar tagihan. Pay the bill. Berbelanja. Berbelanja ke toko. Shop to the market. Menutup. Menutup jendela. Close the window. Membuka. Membuka bungkusan itu. Open the package. Menyetrika. Menyetrika pakaian. Iron the clothes. Melipat. Melipat taplak meja. Fold the tablecloth. Okay, I'm gonna want to tell you how these verbs will be useful for you to add your vocabulary in Bahasa Indonesia or Indonesian language so that you can talk easily and fluently with native speaker in Indonesia. I'm Gunawan Damunsaribu. I'll see you next week at a topic. Goodbye. If you are a student in Indonesia, these 20 verbs usually you use in your daily activity at school, right? Yeah, let's practice, and then I make here also the translation into English so that you know how or the meaning of these verbs in English. Okay, repeat after me. Belajar. Belajar. Belajar means study or learn in English. Second, membaca. Membaca means read. Okay, menulis. Menulis means write. Mengerjakan. Remember? Mengerjakan. Mengerjakan means do, right? Okay, menggambar. Menggambar means draw. Okay, menghitung. Menghitung. Menghitung in English, count. Alright. Mengurangi. Mengurangi. Subtract. Menambah. Menambah. Add. Mendengar. Mendengar means listen or hear. Berbicara. Berbicara means speak. Masuk. Masuk means coming or enter. Keluar. Keluar means get out or exit. Berangkat. Berangkat means leave or go. Pulang. Pulang, go back or return. Bermain. Bermain means play. Beristirahat. Beristirahat means take rest. Mencontek. Mencontek means cheat. Menghapus. Menghapus in English, erase. Tunjuk tangan. Tunjuk tangan, raise hands. The verb is tunjuk or menunjuk. Raise, mengangkat ya. Duduk, duduk, sit. Okay, let's read from the beginning. Belajar, belajar, study or learn. Membaca, membaca, read. Menulis, menulis, write. Mengerjakan, mengerjakan, do. Usually mengerjakan PR means do homework. Okay. Menggambar, menggambar, draw. Menghitung, menghitung, count. Mengurangi, mengurangi, subtract. Menambah, menambah, add. Mendengar, mendengar, listen or hear. Berbicara, berbicara, speak. Masuk, masuk, come in, enter or get in is the same. Keluar, keluar, get out or exit. Berangkat, berangkat, leave or go. Pulang, pulang, go, go back or return. Usually you listen commonly pulang ke rumah, go back home or go home. Right. Bermain, bermain, play. Beristirahat, beristirahat, take rest. Mencontek, mencontek, cheat. Menghapus, menghapus, erase. Tunjuk tangan or mengangkat tangan, raise hands. Duduk, duduk, sit. That's all. If you memorize or you can speak these verbs well, so I guarantee that your Indonesian language be better, and you can use them in your daily speaking with another speaker of Indonesian language. Thank you. This is the Indonesian verbs for workers, usually general workers at office. So in Bahasa Indonesia, this is the 20 most verbs using in an office. So let's practice. Bekerja, bekerja in English work. Berbicara, berbicara in English speak. Berdiskusi, berdiskusi discuss. Berusaha, berusaha try. Beristirahat, beristirahat take rest. Menulis, menulis write. Membaca, membaca read. Mencetak, mencetak print. Mengerjakan, mengerjakan do. Menggunakan, menggunakan use. Menelpon, menelpon, call or telephone. Melaporkan, melaporkan, report. Mengetik, mengetik, type. Mengirim, mengirim, send. Membalas, membalas, reply. Mengunduh, mengunduh, download. Mengunggah, mengunggah, upload. Merapikan, merapikan, tidy up. Menyelesaikan, menyelesaikan, finish. Mempresentasikan, mempresentasikan, present. Let me make one example using an object. Let's try. Bekerja di kantor. Bekerja di kantor. Work in an office. Berbicara dengan klien, speak to the client. Berdiskusi dengan Anda, discuss with you. Berusaha keras, try hard. Beristirahat, beristirahat 30 menit. Take rest within 30 minutes. Menulis surat, write a letter. Membaca buku, read a book. Mencetak laporan, print the report. Mengerjakan tugas, do the task. Menggunakan komputer, use computer. Menelpon client, menelpon client, call the client. Melaporkan tugas, report the assignment, report the task. Mengetik laporan, type the report. Mengirimkan email, mengirimkan surat email, send an email. Membalas surel, reply an email. Mengunduh aplikasi, download an application. Mengunggah laporan, upload an assignment, upload a report, upload a task. Merapikan meja, tidy up a table. Menyelesaikan tugas, finish a task, finish a work. Mempresentasikan laporan, present the report. So I'm Gunawan Tambuncaribu. I do hope this topic will be helpful for you to add your vocabulary in Bahasa Indonesia so that you can be easily to talk to native speaker of Indonesian language. So I'll see you next week, another topic. Thank you, and please like, subscribe, and yeah, you can view my video whenever you want to practice Bahasa Indonesia. Goodbye.